top and glaucoma, which will be followed by a free eye check. I am indeed grateful to them. They will try to take full benefit of their kindness. And now I welcome Dr. Amida to give that talk. Thank you.
Very nice here,
and we are all
so happy to meet you people and discuss and clear your doubts regarding glaucoma. I can help you out with your doubts, or if you have some complaints, you can always share with me. So, may I know, are there anyone who are having or who are undergoing glaucoma treatment now in this gathering? Okay, then what I'm aiming now is I'll give an overlook of what glaucoma is. Everybody know, like glaucoma is a condition where you have eye pressure. Normally every human being have pressure, like in our body there is a pressure which is called, when that pressure is high, we call it hypertension. Like that, we have something called pressure in the eyes. So for normal, everyone is having a normal pressure, but when that becomes higher, then it creates problem. So that is all glaucoma is. When there is a raised eye pressure, we have glaucoma. So what will happen when you have a high eye pressure? When there is a high eye pressure, this thing will compress our nerves. That is, that nerve connection is between our eye to the brain. So when there is a compression of the nerves, you will have decreased vision, and you will ultimately lose your vision. The problem with this condition is, once you have that nerve damage, that is irreversible. So there comes the importance, that is, you have to identify the glaucoma at its earlier stages. So what we aim, and what I aim with my talk here, is to identify that symptoms. I want you all to understand this and take this very seriously and correlate with your health conditions. Like, are you having these symptoms? Should I do this checkups? Should I do checkups frequently? Should I take these tests? You should understand, and you should do this. So as you all know, this week is glaucoma week. So we are trying to spread more of this glaucoma awareness. So I'm starting my presentation. I hope everyone is following me. Everybody is understanding, right? Okay. Thank you. So this is glaucoma awareness. I just want to tell this. Glaucoma means it is the leading cause of irreversible blindness worldwide. That is what I have told you, this is a cause of irreversible blindness. If you are going to be blind because of glaucoma, then you are not going to get back with any kinds of medication. So our main motive is to control glaucoma, to reduce the eye pressure, and not to damage our nerves. So we have to keep the disease under control. Like diabetes, there is no cure for diabetes, we are controlling diabetes like that. So just glaucoma, it is a group of disease which can damage the optic nerve, that nerve which connects your eye to the brain. So initially the main problem with glaucoma is you don't have any symptoms, you don't know whether you have glaucoma or not. So you have to undergo checkups. You have to check your eye pressure, you have to check your nerves, you have to, most importantly, you have to visit your doctor one and check, get your checkups done. So why we are targeting the old age people because they are more prone. Once you cross that 60 years, 50 years limit, then you are more, your eyes have a tendency to develop raised pressure. So that is why we are more attributing age to the glaucoma. The main problem, as I have told earlier, initially they may not show any symptoms. So we have to look for it. We have, the main thing is once it is gone, then it, we cannot do much of it. So that is why once again it is associated with increased eye pressure, which destroys our nerves. That nerve which have which supply to our eye, that nerve is called optic nerve, and that causes decrease in vision. Is there anyone who is from medical field in this group? Okay, fine. This shrinkage of visual field and all means they are just medical terms. That what does it mean is that in glaucoma, what is happening is you can see the central part. Whatever you are having is there is decreased vision in your periphery. Like if I am seeing this way, I can see well. But I can also appreciate who is sitting to my next, who is controlling that. I can see him. I can see that person who is sitting there. That all I can see. But in glaucoma, what happens is that you can that this part of my vision goes. This peripheral part of my vision goes initially. So we must look. That is again an important point. We must look for that. You should look whether you are having a clear view of that peripheral part. That is one symptom of glaucoma. I'll come to details about it. So first, what are the risk factors of glaucoma? That is, risk factors means if you are having certain things, you are more prone to have glaucoma. What are that? The first thing, and as I have told you earlier, age more than 60 years. Then next, there is some racial, that is if you are more of an Asian origin kind of thing, you are more prone to have glaucoma. If you are an Asian, African, among the Africans, Asian, this disease is seen more commonly. Next thing is if you have a family history of glaucoma. That is, if you have a family history, that is if the grandparents are having, then there is higher chance that the son, daughters, they may have the disease occurring at a slightly early age. So there comes the importance of screening of other family members. That is another important thing. And another thing, it is that is more of this height. You are having difficulty in viewing nearer things. That is, as age advances, you all know you need spectacles to read near. So if that difficulty is coming a bit earlier, like by 40 years and all, you are having the difficulty of reading near, then again that your eyes are more prone to develop glaucoma. That is early age of nearsightedness or early age of using the spectacles for reading near. If you have any doubt, you can always interrupt in between. Kindly confirm your doubts and then proceed. And then another thing is you should not use these eye medications over the counter. Every medication, they are having very much side effects. Like prolonged use of this steroid drugs, such things it can all prone for glaucoma. So always never use over the counter medications for your eye. Be very careful about it. And then always this history of diabetes, hypertension, everything is having a risk for glaucoma. Like conditions like heart disease, diabetes. That is, if you have some other problems, systemic problems, heart disease, diabetes, everything is having an association with glaucoma. So saying it all together, it is always better after 60 years you have your glaucoma checkups done at least once in a year. So this is more of water is creating a pressure. See, this water is produced from this part of the eye, and this should go this way and it should go into our blood circulation, and this is that blue arrow. What happens in glaucoma is that this drainage will get blocked. So this won't go outside. So inside that fluid will accumulate. So that is all the pressure is about, and hence the pressure increases. Okay, so sometimes that pressure can rapidly occur, that is that block can occur suddenly in some person. So they may then present with sudden pain, redness, watering and all. That is actually an emergency. But sometimes that does not happen that way. It will be a slow condition, slowly progressive condition. That is this this pathway will slowly block. So that is when you don't have any symptoms. With glaucoma, that water will get accumulated, that pressure, this is the nerve part of the eye. So this pressure will compress that nerve and it will cause the nerve damage. You can see this white thing coming up. The white part of that they can increase. So this is the end stage. That is, it is totally white. Okay. Now I'm coming to the symptoms of glaucoma. Mainly, as I've told you, it is majority of it is not symptomatic. And as I have told you earlier, the loss of peripheral field of vision, early morning headache, eye pain, and as I have told you earlier, there is a sudden increase in pressure. You can always have pain, vomiting, red eye, and all. And another common symptom which people usually say is when we are looking at a bright light. Normally, we may see some brightness around it, but if you see numerous rainbow colors around that white light, then that may be a symptom of glaucoma. So if you have such symptoms, it is always better you have your eye checks done. Now I am going to show you some changes. So these are how you how a glaucoma patient sees when we look. So I think you can appreciate this image. It is more of clear, right? Everyone can appreciate, no? But see the second image. This is the same image, but you can see the black part. This is called the tunnel vision. This is what will happen in an end stage of glaucoma patient. That is, only that central part remains. Periphery will be all black. And that second part you can see, no? That is, there is blur. This is, first one is the current image, but second, third image also you can see there is some blurring. In fourth image, you can see some black spot appearing in your field. Then the fifth image is also like that. Some blurring in the peripheral part of the field, but always the central part is clear. This is another image which is showing. The first one is a normal photo. Second photo, you can see the peripheral black appearing things. Can everybody appreciate that? Okay. Then the next stage is that black part is increasing further, and in extreme cases there is only a central hollow, that is you will feel like you are looking through a pipe, like that vision, tunnel vision it is called, and that only will remain at the last. This is another, so this is very important, that is why I am showing again and again. This is what you should all understand. These are the normal, that is normally a person will see such an image. But in an early stage, there will be numerous black spot kind of thing, and that black spot increases as the disease advances. So this is an end stage of glaucoma where you see only the central part. So how and what to do? We have to undergo vision testing. Like when we check vision, if you have decrease in vision, the doctor can always correlate whether that decreased vision is due to your cataract or any of your nerve problem. And then the second step is we check your intraocular pressure, and then we check your nerves. After that, we have certain tests to correlate with our diagnosis. So by the three steps, we have a diagnosis in our mind, and we then correlate with all these machines and all. We do this visual field testing, and we have numerous OCTs, like several other techniques to confirm our diagnosis. And everything about glaucoma is like diabetes only. You have to have, you should have a close follow-up. Even if you are normal, even if your pressures are normal, you should have a checkup done at least once in 6 months or once in a year. And now coming to the treatment part of glaucoma. Mainly, even though I am telling it as treatment, it is, there is no complete cure for glaucoma. Only thing you can do is you can have a control over your pressure so that it does not damage your nerves. So, I want to tell you what is the normal pressure. It is just 20. 20 is the cutoff. So, anything above 20 means it is abnormal. So, our aim is to maintain that pressure at 20. For that, we have medical management, that is using drops. That is medical management, using drops. Then surgical management is there, that is surgeries, and we have certain lasers also for the same. And now the importance of the medicine. When you are putting medicines, it is very important you put it at a particular time. So our glaucoma medicines is such that if you have, if we are giving you to put it at two times, that is you should be very much careful to put it at a particular time on the same, on a day. That is, what I am meaning is, if you are putting it at 7 o'clock in the morning and 7 o'clock in the evening, every day you should put it that way. Every day 7 o'clock, 7 p.m. 7 a.m., 7 p.m. like that. Or if it is a single use, single time medication, then also you should put it, you should always put it at the same time. Then only the effectiveness will come of the medicines. And now I have also, since there are no glaucoma patients here, it is okay. Otherwise, I have one more slide to show the proper way of putting medicines. So everyone will be having a doubt whether to put one drop, two drop, like that. So always the doctors say you just have to put one drop. Your eye can hold only one drop. Rest whatever you put is going out of your eyes. So that one drop is enough, but you should put it properly. So how will you put? You have to pull your lower lid so that you create a space there. And you just put a single drop. And after, and while putting, you should not touch the tip of your medicine over the eyes. So you put a drop just above your eye, you put a single drop, and after putting the drop, that two upper and lower lid, there is a connection, and you just press it here so that your drop lies in, or it remains in your eye for at least 2 minutes. Then you can get that effectiveness. So this is how you should put a medicine. Just apply a single drop and close it. And now about the follow-up. The follow-up of glaucoma is very important. Like diabetes, you have to have a strict follow-up. You should check intermittently whether you are under control. So the follow-up is very important. You should have a monthly review. After, if you have started on an anti-glaucoma medication recently, definitely you have to go back to your doctor 1 month after that, and then your doctor will check you and reassess you, and accordingly you should schedule your visit as and when doctor advises you. If he is feeling like you are okay, you don't have any problem, and then you can, maybe you need to go to the doctor only after 6 months. But if the doctor feels no, you need more stringent control, you need to have more strict control of eye pressure, then you have to go to him more frequently, maybe twice a week or even monthly. That, that actually your doctor has to decide. So I am coming to the end of the presentation. The take home message is, you should all be aware of this glaucoma. You should protect your eyes and never let glaucoma darken your life. Thank you. So, if any doubts, I'm always happy to clear.
Where to go?
No ma'am, I am coming from Eye Foundation. We have glaucoma consultants there. two or three doctors. All of them have been trained from Aravind Pandur, Aravind Madurai. So Aravind is also in another good hospital.
Aravind also.
Yeah. My foundation, he always preferred us first. After that, we have Aravind. Anyway, you have to get it checked.
This is where this is the two hospitals are there, right?
Yeah. Aravind.
Aravind.
Aravind has three. One. Others are branches.
That is branch of your own concern. Branch of the hospital.
Aravind hospital is 70 days.
That is another hospital. I am coming from my
hospital. Shankara is
there. Shankara is there. Shankara is there. Many hospitals.
How do I strengthen the optic now?
Other exercises or maybe prevent from first place? You can always prevent, sir. Like now we are having more cases. This mobile usage, they are all having a positive correlation. Over usage of eyes definitely is a risk factor.
What is over usage? 12 hours a day? 5 hours a day?
We don't have such a cutoff, sir. But whatever, even if this IT people, they are all looking at the monitors throughout the day. But what we are telling is, you should look at, you should give some rest to your eyes. Even if you are using it continuously, you should stop in between. And after every 3 minutes or 5 minutes, you should stop and you should look at a park place. Or you should have a distance vision. See, nowadays we are having lot of children wearing spectacles. At the same age compared to the because not only because of the mobile, the screen has, that is what the studies have shown, this is what the children is having is myopia that age. So what is happening is now the spaces have reduced. They are not playing outside. Everyone is confined to their home. So that space has reduced. So the children, they are not used to looking at the far places. So that the structural, what to say, the eyes, they are not developing in a proper way. Not like the older things. They are not trained to look at distant places. So their eyes itself is like altered like that. So that is one study that I have shown. So always when we see such kids wearing spectacles right from 2 years, 3 years and all, we always advise them to go outside, play outdoor game. There is nothing like treatment. See, that is a growing age. So up to 14 years, that is going to change. So you should always encourage these children to play outside so that your eyes will grow properly.
What about people our age? Giving
plenty of rest. Yes, sir. Actually, at this point, everything has occurred before. It is nothing like something is going to happen further. So whatever, this is something, this is in our body, that is just showing it at this age.
Can't prevent it now?
No. We can only detect it and control.
There is one sport which they say will cure all eye problems, that is kite flying.
Yeah.
Kite flying is the best. Every eye specialist says, go to the terrace, at least for 15 minutes, fly kite. That's the best exercise they say for the eyes.
Yes, that is another thing I have told you. Encourage outdoor games. You should look at farther places. Then only your eye growth will happen. You should be able to see at distant places. But the exactly opposite thing is happening now. Everybody is looking at that 15 centimeter distance. And mobile usage has increased tremendously. Even small kids, 2 years, 3 years, they are taking food only after seeing these mobiles and all. That should be prevented to prevent all these conditions. So I think we are done with it. We'll proceed to the next step. We'll have the checkups done. Okay.